Greetings to you all in the name of our risen Lord Jesus Christ. The central theme of all the preachings of the apostles during the early church period was the resurrection of Jesus Christ, because for them that was the biggest sign they ever witnessed in their life. So their proclamation focused in these three facts: Jesus is risen, Jesus is still alive, and Jesus will come again. For them, repentance matters in the complete faith in Jesus as the Lord and Savior. Hermann Hesse says that the message of Easter is not simply Jesus lives, rather Jesus is risen. Irenaeus, one of the early church fathers, said that at Easter we celebrate how Jesus set free the weak and endowed his own handiwork with salvation by destroying sin. For he is the most holy and merciful Lord and loves the human race. Now, thousands of our brothers and sisters all over the globe depart their lives miserably due to the present pandemic. We are looking each other with sympathy and meanwhile with fear and brokenness. Dear friends, in this adverse situation of this pandemic world, what is the significance of Easter? Prophet Hosea asks, "Where, O death, are your plagues? Where, O grave, is your destruction?" Hosea chapter 13, verse 14. Later, St. Paul quotes the same and repeats, "Where, O death, is thy victory? Where, O death, is thy sting?" 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 55. In Hosea, it gives hope to the Jews who had been dispersed over the world and had not been able to recover their national independence and had not been able to maintain their national worship. Paul assures that death is defeated and its evils shall be repaired. In both these contexts, these verses give great hope of life. Easter provides us with the hope that there is life possible beyond the fear of death and beyond death itself. On the Easter day dawn, the women reached the tomb, but they saw that the stone was rolled away and the body was missing. They stood confused and frightened. Suddenly, the risen Jesus appeared and reassured them that he was risen from the dead and was alive. The women instantly returned from the tomb as the messengers of that joyful news and shared it. It is the same response we see from Cleophas and his friend, who, after being encountered by Jesus, returned to Jesus' disciples and proclaimed the happy news. "The Lord has risen indeed and has appeared to Simon." The disciples of Jesus carried this same glad news to the ends of the earth. As millions live in total distress today, we as the church is called to proclaim this same good news of hope and life. Easter is a repeated experience where God raises us as individuals and communities from the dead, rolls away the stones that keep us buried, opens the tomb for us to come out in order to celebrate and proclaim the victory of life over death. Easter never happened without the emptiness of God. God emptied himself and became human. Easter event became important because of the death of the Son of God. This is a great challenge for us to be transformed into a real humanity in realizing our limitations, tenderness, and weaknesses. Similarly, Easter also reminds us that God can't die. He is alive and he is at control, especially in the present scenario of the people questioning the very existence of God. Moreover, Easter tells us that the nature of God also can't be perished. The love, truth, honesty, and justice will never be perished. Satyameva jayate. Truth only will conquer. Truth can't be buried for a long time. Evil, injustice, and inequality can't defeat the truth, love, and humility. God will rise again. Death is not the end. Calamity is not the end. Pandemic is not the end. Destruction is not the end. Just like the Lord our God raised his son Jesus Christ from the grave, he will also raise today's fearful world from this pandemic grave. We are locked down as per the instruction of the government for about 3 weeks. Being faithful citizens of our nation, and by looking into the present context, we all must follow the instructions and advice given by the Honorable Prime Minister and the respective Chief Ministers for the welfare of our nation at large. In the first Easter day, when the disciples were locked down due to the fear of Jews, the Bible says that the resurrected Lord appeared among them and wished peace for them. Now, we are also locked down. Our prayer is, let the resurrected Lord give shalom for the whole world in this Easter day. The Bible testifies through all the Gospels that the resurrected Lord appeared to his disciples and friends in several contexts and said, "Fear not, and peace be with you." Dear friends, we will overcome this situation. God will help us to come out of this darkness because he is the light of this world. Let me conclude by saying an ancient popular Persian philosophical thought, "This too shall pass." The Church of South India joins hand in hand and shoulder to shoulder in solidarity with the suffering community of the whole world and our nation. We are obliged to pray for the governments, especially the departments, those who are working in the field of COVID-19, the health workers, police officers, drivers, shopkeepers, and all the volunteers. I encourage all the members of the CSI to plan and work for the welfare of our nation with creative ideas and strategic programs in support of the respective governments in different states. I, being the moderator of the Church of South India, with all humility, along with all our bishops, clergies, lay leaders, and the faithful community, would like to assure our wholehearted support and prayers for all the works being carried out to face this situation by the governmental and non-governmental agencies. May God continue to strengthen us to move forward. I wish all of you a blessed and meaningful Easter with graceful hope and peace. Amen.